What's up, everyone? So first, you'll notice something's a little different on the course there. I made that a little harder. And I want to say thank you to everyone so much. We finally did it. We passed 2,000 subscribers. And that is just awesome. I'm planning on doing a giveaway. I haven't said much about it because, for one, I'm not sure what I can afford to do that with right now, because money is very tight, especially with after the year and everything that we just had. So, yeah, I'm thinking some Treal wheels or something, and I'm also debating if I can do that this revenue cycle, or if for 2,000 subscribers I should get a really nice body to put on my trail finder. I'm thinking the Toyota 4Runner from RC 4-Wheel Drive, and then moving the Toyota Hilux body over to my SCX 10.2 and seeing what we can do with that. So let me know in the comments. I'll do a giveaway this month if I get enough to do it, or I can get that body, but I really kind of want to give back to you guys and do the giveaway. So yeah, I'm going to go over these rigs a little bit for the new subscribers. And again, I can't thank you all enough for watching my videos and supporting my channel. So here we have Treal wheels, which actually narrowed it a tiny bit. Treal aluminum diff cover, Treal aluminum steering links, and Treal aluminum shocks. That's basically all I've done to the Betty. But on the Deadbolt, it has Kinetic-kms double barrel shocks. I've got Kinetic-kms gravy bowl style wheels here. Kinetic-kms millstone wideners and overweights. This is Treal steering links. Hot racing knuckles and diff covers, Kinetic-kms boulder bars, and then underneath, this is just stock underneath, nothing special. But under here we have the barrage motor with a flipped transmission, lowered battery tray, stock ESC. This is a C10 ESC tray to lower the ESC and move the shocks forward. Because in here, it's been four-linked with a Bangear RC E-Max servo tray. And yeah, we have the hot racing skid here, which actually slides pretty good for what it is. And that's the gist. So let's get these things running. It's not going to be a super fair comparison because wide versus narrow and heavy versus light. But it should be a lot of fun. So let's get to it. On with the show. All right, here we go. Deadbolt first. This does have an overdrive in the front too, I forgot to mention, for those of you that might not know that. Stuck in the fence. Now it's the Betty's turn. So there will be flashes in between each truck because I have to switch transmitters to drive them both. It's just me out here doing this. Being this is wider, some lines this will have to take, while other lines the Betty will have to take differently. Stay on there. Nice. Now I'll get Betty's turn to get down the same line. We just can't bridge that gap because it's not wide enough. So we'll have to take a route off to the side. We want to come over this direction and take advantage of the narrow wheelbase and go up this spot. And we're clear. I'll get another angle on that. That same line in roughly the same spot. Then we get up over that. We gotta get up over this hump. Now you can see the Betty go through at this angle. So this one we got to go over to the side. So this is a tricky bit now because I dropped the bridge down and now you have to climb over this. Let that suspension do its work. And I'll get another angle too, don't worry. And now let's see if the Betty can get over it. I put a rock on the other side just in case it can't. This, we're going to have to approach at an angle because of that bumper. And then maybe, just maybe, it'll climb up it. It might not either. It's pretty steep. Let's try that again. This time I'm going to approach just at the rock. There we go. So you can see that overdrive definitely helps the climb, and there's quite a bit more weight up front. We're going to continue this way. Watch the suspension do its thing. If you're wondering, the tires on this are RC four-wheel drive rock creepers. They're actually smaller than the Betty tires, but you can see they have great grip. Now let's see if we can get up the same side with the Betty. Now it's not going to have the wheelbase or the flex to do what the Deadbolt just did. So again, we'll have to approach this a little differently. Still got it though. Oh, I might have spoke too soon. Try that again. Remember, this time I gotta give it a little throttle to get over where it bottoms out. There we go. guys. So now we're up on the famous Smurf Hill here. Gonna come down the usual way. And then we're gonna go up this. No problem at all for the deadbolt. Same with the Betty. And those of you that have been subscribed know that it's probably going to have some trouble here. And that's mainly due to the fact that I don't have as much weight or as wide of a wheelbase. I'm gonna have to take the smart route with this one and work my way over. Come on, Betty, we know you can do it. There it goes. This cheap servo I put in here is doing great too. Now we've got a pretty severe side hill right here. I know the deadbolt will do it, no problem at all. Now let's try the Betty. Not gonna be able to go up on that rock. Hopefully we can make this. Ah, not quite. Y'all know this is a hard line right here. Back to the beginning, and we'll call it the end of this video. I haven't done anything to the transmission on the Betty yet. I'll do that probably when the motor blows or if it really starts annoying me. Right now, a little clicking from the spur gear, I'm almost certain, is what it is, and that doesn't concern me a whole lot. Like I've told people before, there is a warranty on these things. Thank you. so that's the end of this video, everyone. I hope you all enjoyed. And again, thank you all so much for supporting my channel and just watching my videos. I appreciate each and every one of you. And I hope this shows the difference between wide versus narrow wheelbase. You'll see that the diff covers on the wider deadbolt snag a little more because one, smaller tires, but it's wider, so certain lines it'll get hung up on where the Betty doesn't, and vice versa. So yeah, as always, don't forget to like and subscribe. It really helps the channel out, and hit that bell icon so you're notified of when I post. I'll talk to y'all in the next one. TTFN.